938, welcome back. Listen to this. A Cincinnati student is turning his love of the outdoors into his own business. I like that entrepreneurial spirit. This morning we have Gabe Chester, founder of Chester's Outdoor Gear, and he has made something that is phenomenal here. I wouldn't have even thought of doing this. So tell me this. These are all your products here.
Yes.
You make outdoor products. Tell me what led you to this.
So I was looking for a down sleeping bag myself because I do a lot of hiking. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they were too expensive in the stores. And so I was like, I think I'll make one. So I went out and I just stumbled across some materials. I hand sewed the first one. Took me 13 hours to make it. It's like, hey, other people might like this.
Oh, wow.
Maybe it could be affordable for them. And so bought a sewing machine, taught myself to sew, and went from there.
All right, that is, I mean, you know, come on, putting a plan in action. I'm proud of you. Okay, so this is what you came up with. So yes. This, tell us this. I mean, you said 13 hours here. What are you looking for when you're looking for a sleeping bag like this or roll-out sleeping bag like this?
So you're looking for lightweight.
Okay.
So the down makes it able to compress really, okay. Really small. And so this weighs about 1.5 pounds.
Okay.
So people use it on Appalachian Trail, things like that. Big in the hiking community.
Okay. So if you're in hiking, this is where you want to get your stuff here. Now tell us this. You didn't just stop there. You moved on to some other products, right?
Yes, absolutely. So I've actually, these are called grommet socks. I invented that. Put okay. a grommet in the socks. So you hang them on your backpack. Make it so that they can dry if they're wet. They won't fall on the fire.
Okay.
Hats, things like that.
Okay. Explain what it is again, a grommet?
So I put a grommet into wool socks.
Okay.
So then you put a carabiner through it, you can hook it on your backpack.
Oh.
And that way it doesn't fall in the fire or you don't lose it on the trail.
Oh, that typically happens. I mean, really, was there anyone that encouraged you to just kind of make your own here? Or was this just something just out of the blue on top of your mind and you just said, I'm just going to go for it?
You know, I'd say there's probably two big influences. You know, one, really, Cedarville University, which is where I go, their biz law class helped me with like a lot of the legal aspects of the business, and that really I was worried about. That was a big barrier to me entering, starting my own business, and also. You know, just growing up, my dad, I was in Eagle Scouts, things like that. So just growing up in the outdoors really helped prompt this.
Okay, so do we see this expanding? Are we going to see tents now? Or what are we going to see, more camping gear, outdoor gear?
We may, yeah. So I'm actually going to Iceland in May to test some of this gear, some of the most intense environment out there, at least for what I want to do with the gear. Mm-hmm. So we'll just see where it takes us, I guess.
You know what? I'm excited to see it. This is some of the pictures from your adventures. Where were you here?
That was in Spain, in the mountains.
Wow. That is amazing. Okay, so if people want to pick this up, obviously we want to support those who are making something local and doing something so amazing here, kind of fixing a problem on their own. I mean, what's the price point for this here?
So this runs about $75.
Okay.
People can go to my website, chesteroutdoorgear.com. All my products are on there.
Okay, and this goes a little bit cheaper than typical in the stores.
Yes.
How much will one of these run you in the store?
So actually, there's hardly any options, if at all, for this weight,
okay.
1.5 pounds. Most of them are about 3 to 4 pounds,
okay.
And they're anywhere from $300 to $1,000.
Ooh, wow. I didn't realize they cost that much.
Yeah, for down.
Yeah, I don't even understand why it would cost that much, but obviously you've come up with something really creative. So what's the website again?
ChesterOutdoorGear.com.
ChesterOutdoorGear.com. So what we want to know here, when you go to Iceland, we need the pictures, we need the update.
All right.
As if Absolutely. The gear, if it withstands the test here.
Yeah, I'll let you know.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us.
Well,
and congratulations.
You.
If you're interested in picking up his gear, we're going to have this website and this interview on our website, fox19now.com. Just check it out. Congratulations again.
Thank you.
All right.